Hey, what's going on, everyone? Ryan Harry from Ryan Harry Tennis, and today we're going to talk about how to use proper space for optimum pace. Let's do it! Spacing is an absolute must when we're looking to apply a lot of power into our shots. The reason for that is if we don't have the spacing needed to hit the ball off of our body, what happens is we get jammed. And what that's going to do, when jamming us, it's not going to allow us to have proper weight transfer.
Oh, God.
And that's something that as coaches, we see all the time. We see players overrun the ball all the time, and even underrun the ball at times. And it's very simple to do, right? In tennis, we have so much going on that when the ball is hit from the other side, it's very, very simple to just see that yellow thing floating up and to run at it or run to it. But what we're looking to do is actually set up for the bounce of the ball and set up for the swing itself. And to do that, we have to apply some specific principles to be able to do that time and time and time again. So today we're gonna go over a couple different progressions of how you can learn proper spacing on the forehand side and how that can enhance your power. The first progression is gonna sound pretty simple, but oftentimes it's a little bit confused. I'm gonna ask you to drop and just hit the ball, okay? One thing you'll notice is that you might be dropping the ball a bit too close to you or a bit too far away from you. What we're looking to do is from a side position, we're looking to extend our non-dominant arm across our hips, out at shoulder level, and as far as extended as you can go without breaking your posture. We're not looking to lean into any particular space. We're just trying to apply it from a side position, across our hips, across our body. The non-dominant hand is still in front of me, right? I'm not curling it back to drop it behind me. The ball will still be located in front of my hips, but I do want optimum space. I do want that proper space across on the outside of my body as well. Why? So that I can swing through and my racket is now going to meet that ball proper space off of my hips, right? And off of my body. That's gonna allow me to get through the ball. Okay, everyone, so now we have a pretty good sense of how to just drop and then hit off the bounce. We're providing that proper spacing. And now we're gonna move into a live setting. We're not gonna go all the way back. We're gonna go about halfway back into mini tennis territory. And what we're gonna do is your partner is gonna hit the ball to you, okay? And you're gonna instantly create the space that we just learned and worked on. But since it's a live ball, what we're gonna do is have to adjust our feet to keep the spacing, right? That's absolutely essential in this drill. We wanna make sure that we're moving our feet so that we have proper spacing and that we're keeping proper spacing so that we can have a nice, clean, powerful hit later on. All right, so I'm gonna go back. All right, Noah's gonna hit a ball. I'm just gonna adjust, instantly finding my space, and I'm gonna apply footwork to keep that space, all right? Now, if Noah hits a ball more at me, then I have to move maybe perhaps laterally, okay? See how I have to move away from that ball, all right? If he hits a little bit shorter or lower, I might have to move in and down to catch that ball to hit properly, right? So we're constantly adjusting for proper space so that we can have that proper swing. Okay, everyone, so now we're putting it into live play, all right? We've worked on it enough, and now we can apply it to actual play itself. So we're gonna be hitting a live ball here. Whether it's a fed ball to you or from a ball machine or just rallying from the baseline, I want you to try to create that space time in, time over and over again to create that repetition so that when time comes to apply the power, that space is there for you. It's gonna allow you to swing clean through that ball. You're gonna feel so good about that shot, so smooth coming off that racket. And if we're doing this, then we're gonna be able to apply a ton of pace, right? We're gonna be able to get our body into that ball. We're gonna be able to step in through that ball. We're gonna be able to turn our hips through that ball. We're gonna be hitting the biggest ball we've ever hit. Okay, everyone, so I hope you enjoyed that video. Remember, apply that space to have that pace. If you like this video, please click the like button, subscribe to my channel for more videos, and push that bell notification. That way, you have access to all my oncoming videos. All the best to you, and let me know how it goes. Thanks, see ya.
Ah! Yeah, you're running into the ball.
You want me to run into the ball?
No, you are doing that. We don't want you to do that.
Don't.